Hi, this is Dave Dirks from Dirks Outdoors. I recently attended the 2017 fly fishing show in Somerset, New Jersey, which is an excellent show. If you haven't been there, that's a show you need to go at. And it travels around the United States, happens to be probably the largest and the finest fly fishing show of scale anywhere in the United States. I bring my video camera with me when I do go, and my intent is to find a couple of fly tyers of the many excellent fly tyers that are there who are willing to get in front of the camera and share their knowledge and insights, particularly their tying recipes at the time. Bruce Corwin is a good friend of ours in the fly fishing world. Bruce, actually I've filmed Bruce before doing some other patterns on the DirksOutdoors YouTube channel. And I saw Bruce there. He had an interesting looking fly that I hadn't seen in a while. I had heard about it, I think it was through the Wall Street Journal. And of course, Bruce confirmed that this particular fly pattern called the Mop Fly apparently caused some stir a few years ago when the Wall Street Journal posted an article about it, basically saying that it was one of those flies that caused all kinds of controversy because it was made from the materials of a mop. And it doesn't look like a conventional fly, although it looks like a big, nutritious meal to me when I look at it. So anyway, Bruce spent a few minutes showing us how to tie this fly, which is what the segment is all about. And I can guarantee you I'm going to have this fly in my box this spring. I'm going to test it, give it a good workout this spring and summer, and see for myself whether I think it's an effective fly pattern. It looks pretty effective. I will again try it myself. It's very easy to tie, and I encourage you to try it yourself. Anyway, here's Bruce Corwin tying the Mop Fly.
Hi, my name is Bruce Corwin. We're at the fly fishing show in Somerset, New Jersey, and today I'm going to be demonstrating a fairly recent controversial fly that's called the Mop Fly. Back in October of 2016, the Wall Street Journal featured an article about this new tremendous fly that was called the Mop Fly, and literally, it is a mop fly. We take this and we end up with this. So, without any further ado, let's get some tying done. Okay, so let's get started and tie a mop fly. Basically, we are going to be using a material that comes off of a standard mop that's available in supermarkets, and without naming any big box stores, they're readily available. They come in green, they come in blue, they come in pink. But today we're going to use a chartreuse. What I've done is I've affixed a 7051 shrimp and caddis pupa hook in my vise, and I have a 1/8 inch tungsten bead on there. I'm going to start my thread right behind the bead and lay down a touching turn thread base to just about the point of the hook. And now I'm going to bring my thread back, spiral it back just behind the bead, and now we take our piece of mop that we've cut off of the big chunk of mop. And what I'm going to do is pick out some of the strands till I get to the center core of the piece. And now what I'm going to do is lay it against the bead and just catch it in and tie it down behind the bead. And what I'm actually going to be doing is creating a ramp for the next material that we're going to be putting on here. So this fly has a lot of controversy behind it. Purists are saying it's not actually a real Catskill fly or an attractor. Basically, it catches trout, and it catches bass, and it catches panfish, and it's a good all-around attractor pattern. So what I have in my hand now are three pieces of peacock curl. What I'm going to do is double that peacock curl over my thread and pull it down into position. And now I'm going to wrap that peacock curl right behind the bead, tuck it right in, Now I'm going to catch it in, trap it down, take a couple of wraps behind, and trim it down. And since I haven't really tied a chenille or made a chenille out of the peacock curl, I'm going to just take my thread and spiral it through the peacock to lock it in. The next step is I'm going to take some CA adhesive. You can use a brand or just plain crazy glue or whatever is available to you. Put this adhesive on the first inch or so of my thread, and I'm going to wrap this thread in behind the bead. And that crazy glue will lock everything in. And now I'm going to do a five-turn whip finish right behind the bead against the bead and tie it off. And there you have the very technical mop fly. The fly is actually fished by just dropping it down. The tungsten bead will take it down, let it drift in the current, or you can take short strips. And usually, my experience is that upon the lift, the bottom of the fly will wiggle around, will do its thing as it's lifting, and you usually get hit on the rise. So good luck with your mop fly. By the way, I have a new book out that features some fairly classic flies, some new flies, some watercolor paintings, and some patterns that I've tied over the years that you might want to know a little bit more about. The book is available at www.brucecorwin.com, and give it a look.